More now on our top story, the explosive claims by the former CEO of Australia Post that she was bullied out of the top job by the Prime Minister after buying four Cartier watches for staff.
I was humiliated by our Prime Minister for committing no offence and then bullied by my chairman. I was seriously ill. I was on temazepam. I was suicidal. I was thrown under the bus so the chairman of Australia Post could curry favour with his political masters.
Such powerful words there. And former Australia Post CEO Christine Holgate joins us now in Canberra. Christine, thanks for your time this morning. Firstly, have you heard from the Prime Minister yet?
No, I haven't.
Do you think you will? I honestly think you will. And what would you say to him if he calls?
You know, everybody makes mistakes sometimes. And if he was to call me and apologise, I would welcome that apology. That's all I want. It's all the people have wanted. We just want respect. We just want to stop to bullying and humiliation.
After everything you went through and after everything, especially when he stood up in Parliament and said the words he did and how that affected you, clearly we saw yesterday, how that affected you on a very personal way and your mental health, you would accept it and move on.
Well, I want to. You know, Carl, it's been a dreadful period of time. It wasn't just 5 months ago. It's been continuous what the organisation's put me through. But I am stronger today and I think a better leader for it because thousands of people across our fantastic country have come out and supported me and it's just been amazing. Mm. And you know, standing up against bullying is bloody hard. Mm. And trust me, because you feel alone. But God, have I learned the most wonderful thing about Australia and the human nature of people.
Mm. Just how tough have the past 5 months been? I think we got an insight into it yesterday and we've been talking, like to get to the top, to be the CEO of a business, you have to be very, very tough. I think if you're female, you perhaps even need to be tougher. To see you yesterday and to see and to hear how this almost broke you, what does it tell us?
It almost broke me, Ellie, but it didn't break me. And I will come back stronger. But my God, I'm lucky, you know. I had these thousands of post offices fighting for me. I had people in the street. Just imagine if you're just an ordinary mum and dad and this happens to you. And you don't get the benefit of all those people knowing you and doing this. It was incredibly hard. And it wasn't just that day. It wasn't just what happened in Parliament. You know, to be hung in Parliament and then to watch your own chairman, you know, actually lie. And not just lie to me, lie to the people of our country. And not just about me, about really important matters, about reviews, about the future of Australia Post. I love Australia Post. It's a national treasure. The people are amazing who work there. Nobody should lie, and people should be held accountable when they do so.
Why do you think the PM went so hard and so quickly? It's been labelled this morning in News Limited as cheap outrage. What do you think it was?
I don't know, Carl, and I don't really know if it's great to speculate either. But you would kind of hope that if you were running the largest GBE, that's the government business enterprise in the country, the largest one. I also co-chair the trade board for him. I chair another board to do with Australia and ASEAN. You kind of hoped he would have picked up the phone and spoke to me, or if not him, the minister, before they did this. But when they spoke in Parliament, nobody said, hold on a minute, this was 2 years ago. This was for bringing in the largest ever investment into community post offices. It saved the post offices. It kept banking in rural and regional Australia. 55% of communities in Australia have no bank. If it was not for Commonwealth Bank, NAB and Westpac, we wouldn't have banking in the post office. Those communities would not have access to money. And who that does that harm? Small businesses will go to the pub. Check that out. I might have said the wrong thing, and I sincerely apologise if I did. But I'm telling you, what happened to me was not fair. And if I don't stand up, Carl, what kind of leader am I? How can I ever ask people to work for me? So I needed to stand up. It's been very hard. You can probably tell I'm still passionate and emotional about it. But, you know, it's the right thing. It's got to stop.
Are you okay now?
Do you know, it was a very big thing. I don't think it will ever leave me. And in many ways, I hope it never does. Because I hope that I'll always remember what it felt like to be Davina fighting Goliath. Because I hope that makes me a more compassionate and understanding leader going forward. So you can't get run over and then say, I'm completely okay now. You can't be. Not if you're a person with real compassion. You know, we've all got feelings. But an apology would help, Carl.
Mostly, you can see what the Prime Minister was doing, and that's trying to leap on this whole idea and notion of corporate fat cats being out of touch with the rest of Australia, buying Cartier watches. Would you concede, at the very least, to the general public that was a bad look?
I can understand for many people it was a bad look. But it's the general public, by the way, who've been the people who've got me to stand here today to talk to you. I think, you know, I'd love you to talk to the lady who runs the post offices. You know, I can see how they view that. What they never say was, this deal brought in, just that one, those three transactions, 22 million in GST for the government. You know, it saved banking in community post offices. Perhaps next time I won't buy someone a Cartier watch. But let me tell you something. I never want to stop rewarding and recognising brilliance in my people. These are four outstanding people who worked continuously to get this over the line. No one thought we could do it. It wasn't in anyone's objectives because no one believed we could do it. The service was going to close. It was losing $48 million. Do you know there'd been no investment in the post office, technology investment, for 30 years? 30 years. This is what this did. It didn't just save banking. It enabled us to invest in those community post offices. Well, I reckon, Carl, and Ali, if you asked your viewers what's really important in your community, do you want your post office to stay or not, they would come back with a resounding yes. Mm. And what we were doing is standing up and fighting for them.
Look, I mean, I think the $20,000, it's small change when you now look at what the amount of money that's been spent trying to find a replacement CEO in the investigation into the Cartier watch debacle, you might call it. But can I ask who you were more disappointed with? Is it the Prime Minister or is it your own chairman?
It is the chairman, undoubtedly. He was the person who briefed the minister. He's the person who spoke to the minister before this event. He's the person who's supposed to step for me. He unlawfully stood me down. And then at a moment, at my lowest point, 10 of most harrowing days of my career, I offered to resign. I send him a statement to justify to him, I'm not going to say anything bad about the government or all of them. Please help me get a solution. It gets leaked. And it only went to them. So they can't say it was me or anybody else. It went to them. They leaked it. You know, it's been just the most disgraceful act of bullying. We have contracts, as all employees do. At no point have they ever respected that contract. It is a disgraceful act of humiliation, bullying, intimidation. Call it what you like. But that's not what this fantastic company needs as a chair and a board.
I'm sure, though, you've had a grovelling apology from the chairman.
I wish I had. He still has not apologised.
You are joking.
He has not apologised. You know, I am not joking, Carl, and you know, I'm sorry. Forgive me. You know, yesterday, I had to hear him say I was treated abysmally, but I deserve no apology. Mm. Just answer that.
I feel for you. I feel genuinely for you in that regard. I think this guy's got to step down. The way that he's handled this whole thing, I know that will probably not mean the world to you, but it's something. And I think the Prime Minister needs to apologise for you. It's the least he can do to you. You've been through a lot. I can feel your pain. I think the whole of Australia can feel your pain.
And heard you very clearly, Christine, yesterday. I think it took so much to front that inquiry, to sit there for so long and to answer those questions, but you did yourself a great service, and I know most Australians were applauding your efforts yesterday, so thank you.
Thank you, Ellie, and thank you, Carlin. Can I also say thank you to all the Australians watching your program, because I couldn't have done it without them, without their incredible support, and I'm so deeply appreciative. Okay. I won't let them down. I'll come back from this fighting.
Good on you. Christine Holgate, we'll see you again real soon, I reckon.
Thank you.
And if you or someone you know is struggling, please call Lifeline on 13 11 14. Strong woman, brave. Mm.